3 years, Chris and I would visit a local movie theater and play one of our favorite arcade games, the Simpsons Arcade game, while we waited for the movie to start. But recently, we arrived at the theater early, our pockets jingling with quarters, only to find to our horror that the arcade cabinet was gone.
This review is a tribute to the memory of that game, and all of the many years of good times it gave us. The Simpsons Arcade game will never forget you.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life.
In the early 90s, The Simpsons were everywhere. They were the biggest thing since the Ninja Turtles. Their faces were on billboards, magazine covers, commercials, toys, and t-shirts. Everywhere you looked, Bart was telling you to eat his shorts. To capitalize on the popularity of the show, Konami released The Simpsons Arcade game in 1991.
The saddest thing about the loss of this arcade game is the fact that it was only ever ported to one home console, the Commodore 64. And its hardware limitations couldn't accurately recreate the graphics and speed of the original.
We salute the Commodore 64's valiant efforts, but a classic side-scrolling beat-em-up like this really needed a more competent platform, like the NES, Super Nintendo, or Sega Genesis. And why don't the Wii Virtual Console or Xbox Live Arcade jump on board? We'd even purchase a PlayStation 3 if it was necessary to legally play this game in the comfort of our own home.
Until then, you'll have to find a Simpsons arcade cabinet like the one we used to play at the movie theater. If you can find one, it's totally worth the quarters.
There are literally hundreds of other Simpsons video games out there, but they all suffer from poor control and mediocre gameplay. And they aren't anywhere near as fun as the Simpsons arcade game. It's our favorite kind of game, a side-scrolling beat-em-up, featuring all of the Simpsons characters we know and love.
Maggie has somehow obtained a giant stolen diamond and mistaken it for a pacifier, and Mr. Burns and Smithers have kidnapped her to retrieve it. So it's up to the Simpson family, Homer, Marge, Bart, and Lisa, to rescue Maggie from Mr. Burns' evil clutches.
Each character has different moves and weapons. Marge wields a vacuum cleaner, Lisa swings a jump rope like a whip, and Bart bludgeons people with his skateboard. Homer's the only one who doesn't have a weapon. He just punches people and flails his legs around when he jumps, like Luigi in Super Mario 2.
When you're playing with a friend, you can also perform combo attacks, which seem to be initialized just by standing still in close proximity to each other.
You've got your basic beat-em-up moves, attack, jump, and a combination move, which amazingly doesn't use any of your energy.
That and the fact there's no damage between players earns this game the Chris and Jen beat-em-up seal of approval.
We're Chris and Jen, and we approve this game.
You fight some recognizable Simpsons characters and a few new enemies, including these men in business suits.
You also recognize other characters in the background, like Moe, Milhouse, Nelson, and Bleeding Gums Murphy. You know, he should really get those gums looked at. He may have the gum disease known as
gingivitis.
You can pick up all kinds of random items and use them as weapons, like mailboxes, soda cans, tires, bowling balls, rocks, bottles, and even animals like three-eyed fish, Santa's little helper, and Snowball 2.
The levels take place in various Simpsons-related settings, like Krusty Land, Moe's Tavern, and the nuclear power plant. My favorite is the Springfield Discount Cemetery.
There's even a creepy grayscale Dreamland, where giant walking donuts attack you by throwing smaller donuts at you, and flying saxophones drop deadly music notes on you.
And the boss is a giant, angry-looking bowling ball. Frightening.
You'll find all the usual beat-em-up standards, like an obligatory elevator level, and the blinking disembodied hand that tells you where to go. And we love that hand. All games should have that hand.
There are also lots of appearances by this guy Binky. No, not the terrifying clown from Garfield. The weird bunny-looking guy from this little-known Matt Groening comic strip called Life is Hell.
Binky shows up all over the background of this game, among other Springfield staples. And check out this cute little Simpsons arcade cabinet.
When you finally face Mr. Burns and Smithers, you might notice something a little off about them.
Welcome to my world.
Up and at 'em.
Their voices, they're all wrong. They don't sound anything like the characters from the show.
Welcome to your grave.
What happened here? The voices of the Simpson family are all perfect, but Konami failed miserably in the casting for the two main bosses.
You fight Mr. Burns in this big mechanical suit, and when you kill him, Maggie appears and sticks her pacifier into his mouth.
Then she discards the giant diamond on the side of the road as they walk away. I take issue with that. I mean, it's worth a lot of money. If they can't sell it on the black market, they could at least get some kind of reward for returning it to the jewelry store from which it was stolen. The Simpsons aren't exactly rolling in dough. It's even worse than when the old lady chucks the necklace into the ocean at the end of Titanic. It fills me with 90s rage.
Now reunited with their bundle of joy, the Simpsons walk toward the glittering lights of Springfield.
In closing, we would like to issue an appeal to the makers of video game consoles, Nintendo, Microsoft, and Sony. Please bring the Simpsons arcade game to one of your consoles so everyone can enjoy its classic beat-em-up goodness, no matter how many movie theaters remove its cabinets from their lobbies.
We'll miss you, Simpsons arcade game. Going to the movies will never be the same.
How do I say goodbye? The good time that made us laugh, I'll wait back. I thought we'd get to see forever, but forever's gone away. It's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday.
Without a doubt, the worst episode ever. Rest assured that I was on the internet within minutes, registering my disgust throughout the world. Shh.